We've recently saw the new toroidal propeller design made by MIT and thought immediately we should attach them to our fastest 3D printed underwater drone.
Go.
So in this video we'll do just that, to test if they will be more efficient, faster, and if they won't chop you to little pieces like the original ones would.
Before we dive right into it, let's figure out what's the actual difference between a toroidal propeller and the normal propeller. So this is a normal propeller. It's basically made of three wings, revolves around its axis of rotation, which moves the water as the propeller rotates. A toroidal propeller is basically the same, but in this example, there are six wings, which are connected together at the tips of the propeller. So why would this help with anything? A wing, as it generates lift, creates a high pressure area under the wing and a low pressure area over the wing. The air always wants to travel from the high pressure area to the low pressure area. So if we look at this from the back, at the tip of the blade, the water will want to flow from the bottom of the wing to the top of it, causing a big mess, which will cause the thrust generated by the propeller to decrease. A toroidal propeller connects these two edges from the two blades together, which just eliminates these edges, which eliminates the wingtip vortices, so it means more thrust. That's it. On the other hand, adding this connection between the blades adds additional surface, which does not generate thrust. Therefore, it just adds drag. Of course, there are also a bunch of other aspects which could make this propeller less or more efficient.
We're gonna use CPS5S for this, so we just designed the propellers to mimic the original ones that were installed in the CPS5. Okay, so we came up with two designs. This design is inspired by the shape of boat propellers made by Sharrow, which they have been making for some time now. And this is a design inspired by the toroidal propellers made by MIT, which they tested for flying drones. We basically modified the pitch a little bit and made it a little higher to adapt it for rotating in the water instead of the air. But their working principle is basically the same. The difference is that the blades of this one curve in a different way than the blades of this one. Right, let's get everything assembled.
We've recently absolutely destroyed our drone in the last video. So let me just fix it real fast. Great. Now we need to print the propellers. Here are the boat propellers. And here are the MIT ones. Now we need to smooth them out. However, sanding these would be very hard. That's why we printed them in ASA material, which can be treated with acetone vapor. We put some acetone in the box and then the props. The goal is to melt them a little bit on the surface. What the fuck? No, shit. We left them for a little too long. Here we go again. Here you can barely see how they get smoother over a few hours. They look great. Now we can go test them.
Today is an exceptionally hot day for testing the propellers. We were swimming before and now we're gonna test the f***ing propellers.
This is the start line.
Okay, so I'm gonna do 3 meters.
If you want to build our underwater drone yourself, we have an online course in which we share all of the 3D models, schematics, software, and a bill of materials, and then teach you how to assemble CPS5 step by step. We even have lessons which explain how each part of the drone could have been built differently. Go to cpsdrone.com to get started, but now wait, we have the results for the toroidal propellers.
And this is the finish line.
That's the finish line. Alright.
First, the standard propellers. As mentioned in the previous video, we got these as a gift from people who designed the military underwater drone.
and we figured they will fit our drone since we use similar motors. So we're just gonna use the speed test with these as a benchmark for the toroidal propellers. We never can get over how fast the CPS5S is, so we need to be very careful to not crash it again. After 3 speed tests, we got the average of 2.99 meters per second. We also used our patented zucchini test to see how safe each spinning propeller is to your finger.
This could have been your finger, kids.
Yes. Now the toroidal propellers inspired by the MIT design.
Wow, that looks so cool.
We weren't sure if this was gonna work at all, but after putting it in the water, it felt just like normal propellers.
Whoa.
So, was it faster? The average maximum speed is 2.26 meters per second. Comparing these to the standard ones, they are quite a bit slower. Let's chop some zucchini. It appears to be way safer than the standard one.
Whoa, that's incredible.
Yes.
It's barely even a damage.
Nice.
It's way better. Maybe we don't even need hubs and we just need toroidal propellers.
This was unexpected. They definitely have some potential. And finally, let's test the toroidal propellers inspired by the Sharrow design. These feel faster than the MIT ones. The average maximum speed here is 2.52 meters per second. That's better. Still not as good as the standard propellers, but only very slightly, I would say.
159.
Let's see if maybe they are also slightly less dangerous.
No.
It's hard to judge, but I would say that they are indeed slightly less dangerous because they don't make a sharp cut, but rather eat it chunk by chunk.
At least it's not hungry anymore.
A finger would definitely be cut though. We also measured how much power each motor and propeller draws at max speed. And it turned out that with the standard propeller, the drone consumed about 984 watts, with the MIT-inspired propellers about 1079 watts, and with the Sharrow-inspired propellers about 1045 watts. The most ideal place to be at this graph is at the bottom right, since that's the place where the propeller makes the drone really fast without drawing a lot of power.
Now please, don't base your opinions on these numbers. We literally designed these propellers by eye in one day in order to compare them to normal props. And propeller design is a very complex task on which you can spend literally thousands of hours and millions of dollars. Also, remember, if you want to build an underwater drone yourself, check out the CPS5 online course in which we teach you how to build the CPS5 step by step.